Guys, welcome back. Okay, so today I'm playing around in this Glam Light burger palette. You guys see this packaging, this box is humongous, and so is the palette, but it's super duper cute. It comes in this diner style packaging, and the actual palette looks like and feels like a real bun. It's soft and squishy, but as you can see, this is a giant palette, super cute. Yes, I'm being obnoxious, so just ignore me. I just can't believe how cute this palette is. But let's go ahead and just talk about it. There are 16 shadows in this palette, which consists of 32 grams of product, or each shadow is 0.07 ounces. It is from Glam Light, like I said. It is vegan and cruelty-free. Now, out of these shadows, well, you can see here there's a mirror in the palette, and the shadows are actually placed on a slice of cheese on top of the burger, which I think is just so cute. Now, if you're a regular viewer of mine, when I first saw this palette, I was like, I'm not fooling with it. I'm not dealing with no food, but it was just too cute and I couldn't resist. So the 16 shadows consist of 6 shimmers and 10 mattes. Now, I have mixed feelings about this palette because when I first saw it being used, I was like, oh my gosh, those shadows are just remarkably pigmented, especially the matte shade, but they are extremely powdery. So if you're not really comfortable or familiar with using powdery shadows, then this might be a little difficult for you to use. But as you can see, they are very pigmented. The shimmers look absolutely gorgeous going on and swatching, but my experience with using the palette was not as enjoyable as I thought it was going to be. The shimmers just weren't as impressive on the eyes to me as I expected, but the matte shadows, like I said, extremely pigmented, and I did enjoy using those once I got used to them. So this is the palette, you guys. Very cute. Let's just go ahead and jump into this look. So I'm using my new L'Oreal Infallible Concealer to set my lids today because I felt like I needed a little bit of a tacky base to use these extremely pigmented shadows. So I'm starting off with red onions first, and I'm just placing that in the outer corner of my eye. And as you can see, it's coming off pretty nicely pigmented. I did go ahead and build it up. It didn't take too much work to build it up, but the color is very, very gorgeous. That's one thing I do love about this palette is the color scheme in here. The beautiful greens and reds are just super pretty. Now I'm going into ketchup. As you can see, the names go along with the theme of the palette, but I'm just placing ketchup right next to red onions and just kind of blending the edge of those two red shades together. I want to create a bit of an ombre effect, so I'm just gently tapping and blending those into each other. And ketchup is pretty pigmented as well, as you can see, and they blend together very nicely. I would definitely say you need to use a tapping motion when placing these shadows. Now I'm going into what is my favorite shadow in the palette, which is Sweet Potato Fries. It is this gorgeous, beautiful orange matte shade, and it's extremely powdery, you guys. This shadow has so much fallout in the palette. I was just like, oh my goodness. But the color payoff is remarkable. I mean, it's just extremely vibrant, very, very pretty. And as you can see, it blends in super nice with ketchup. But yeah, the kick up in the pan is real for this shadow. And it's strange because there's not a lot of kick up for all the colors, just that one. Now, next I'm going into this beautiful green shade, which is Spinach. I wanted to place that on the inner corner. Wanted to do something a little different. Instead of placing the green in my outer corner, I went ahead and put it in my inner corner as a change of pace. And as you can see, it is mad pigmented. It's not a color that you would typically try to blend in with orange, but I made it work. Now I'm gonna go ahead and cut my crease with my Revolution Cut Crease Canvas. and I'm just taking this across my lid. There was a little bit of color that bled through the cut crease canvas, but I didn't mind. I just went ahead and rolled with it. So first I'm starting off with this shimmer shade lettuce, which is really pretty. It's a gorgeous light color shimmer shadow. It's like a lime green color. And I'm just placing that on the inner corner. Now I'm going into blue cheese. Now this is where I really began to kind of feel a bit disappointed with this shimmer shadow. It just did not come off on my lid like I thought it would. I don't know. Maybe I was just having a bad day, but the blue just did not pop the way that I thought it would. So I was not happy with that color at all. You guys know I never use my fingers to place shadows, but I said maybe I better use my finger with this one. So I went in with my finger and it did show a little bit better, but I'm not feeling this color, you guys. It is not the color that I thought it would be. So, plan B. I'm going to take this green shade pickles and start to place that on my lid. As you can see, I did spray my brush. So I just went in with pickles and placed it on top of blue cheese just to kind of see how it would look or how I would like it if I mixed those two together. And as you can see, I'm still not pleased. So I just go in with a little bit more red onions and just kind of smoke out my outer corner just to bring this eye look together and make it a little bit more cohesive, you know, with all of these colors on my eyes. I'm cleaning up my mess before I move on to some eyeliner, and I'm just using my black liquid eyeliner as usual from Wet n Wild, creating a nice thin wing for this look. So this is what the eye look is looking like so far. I'm going to go ahead, finish up my base makeup and come back so we can do the lower lash line. So, hey y'all, I'm back. Now I'm going in with this green eyeliner, one that I got from my kit that I bought from Amazon, and just using that on my lower lash line. Now I'm going to take ketchup, smoke out that lower lash line a little bit just to bring some of that red down on my lower lash line, and I'm going back into this beautiful sweet potato fries. You guys, I really like this color. Honestly, that's my favorite color of the palette. It's just a gorgeous warm orange shade. It's so pretty to me. But I'm placing that on my inner part of my lower lash line. Now I'm going back into lettuce just to add that pop of shimmer on my lower lash line as well. And just trying to complete this whole eye look. Look at that highlighter, y'all. It should pop and got my nose shining. I don't remember what highlighter it was. So I'm using my favorite lip liner, my Ellery lip liner today. And I'm going in with one of my ColourPop lipsticks. Which one is this? This one is Get a Room. It's a beautiful bright orange color, but I'm mixing it in with that burgundy just to tone it down a bit. And I'm setting this with my Morphe Continuous Setting Spray today. So, you guys, this is the look. I really like the look, although I wasn't that happy with how some of the shimmer shadows performed on my lid. I definitely am going to play around with this palette some more because I do love the mattes, and maybe I'll just try some different looks with the shimmers. But hopefully you enjoyed this look today. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you on the next one. Toodles!